on our seventh limb right now, and it's called Dhyana. Now, Dhyana is very something we are aware of. Dhyan, you know, we say Dhyan rakhine halo, Dhyan rakhine. Dhyan means what? To be focused on that particular stuff that you're talking about. So Dhyan karo, meaning, so that's the same language that is used here is the Dhyana, they call it, okay? And it's mainly, it's very connected to dharana, which was focus on a point. This one is now assimilating the focus on internal everything, not just one aspect of the focal point. So it's actually a step towards meditation, which is the last step we will do next time, okay? All right, so let's all start. Sit at the edge of the chair. Make sure your knees are above your ankle in a straight line, all right? Toes are pointing forward, hands to heart, thumbs touching your sternum. And let's start and do some breathing and moving, okay? Take a deep breath in, inhale, up, 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 inhale, up, 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 as far as you can go. And exhale slowly down. Exhale down, 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 down. Right back to your heart. Smile. You're here, we're all here. Inhale. Take a deep breath in. Inhale, inhale, inhale. And slowly exhale. Remember, breathing is really important, especially at this time. Make your lungs strong. Take a deep breath. Inhale, inhale. Keep inhaling till you come up right to the top. And slowly exhale through your nose. Exhale. Inhale up again. This time, bring out your arms nice and wide. Look up, inhale. Exhale, look down, touch your palms. Inhale up. Exhale, look down. Inhale, look up again. Exhale, look down. Last one. Inhale. Exhale. Slow exhale. And bring your hands back to your heart. Deep breath in. Inhale. Feel the rise and fall of your chest. So let's put one hand on your chest, one hand on your tummy. All right? Make sure you're feeling the rise and fall as you breathe in and out. All right? Inhale. And exhale slowly out. Inhale again. Exhale slowly out. Last one, inhale. Exhale slowly out. Arms out wide, inhale. Exhale with other arm on top. Reverse. Inhale out. Nice and wide, breathe in, exhale, reverse your arms. So you're using your arms to reverse, so you're using your brain as well as your breath. Thinking, dhyana. And think of your arms coming, reversing. Exhale, big inhale, exhale, big inhale again. Exhale, last one. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. And put your arms back on your lap. Take a deep breath in. Inhale. Shoulders up. Exhale, slowly down. Inhale, up. Exhale, slowly down. Inhale, up. Exhale, slowly down. Let's rotate our shoulders, up and back. Inhale, exhale. High as you can take them. Up high, inhale. Near your ears, possible. Not too close, but whatever you can do. Feel it in the upper back, upper shoulder, upper neck area. Nice and relaxed. And let's do the opposite. Opposite, very good. Very good, smile, inhale, exhale, one more, and down. Bring your arms down to the side and shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. Take a deep breath, inhale, Exhale, come down, 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 down. Touch wherever you can. Raise your other arm up, look up. And then come back down slowly. Inhale up. Exhale slowly down. One more time, inhale. Touch wherever you can. Look up, come down slowly. Inhale up. Exhale down. Arms out wide. And then cross. Cross your arms as far as you can go back. If you're here, that's fine too. But if you can go further, then that way you're giving your shoulder joints a little bit more rotation. So go just as far as you can. Inhale. Exhale out. Inhale again. Other arm on top. Remember, reverse. Inhale. Nice and wide. Exhale. Again, give yourself a nice little hug. Inhale out. Other arm on top. And one more time. Inhale. Last one. Exhale. And see this time, if you can bring your elbows up. Inhale. And elbows down. Inhale up. Elbows up. Exhale down. Don't judge. Do whatever you can. You are here today. Shukar. We are all here. We are safe. Inhale. Exhale. Arms wide. And come behind your head. Touch the, clasp your fingers and bring it behind your head. And then see if you can bring your elbows together and out. Inhale. Exhale. Just move your elbows together. It won't go together because your head is in the way, obviously. But you're still rotating. Out. And very good. One more. And bring it down. Very good. And shake it out. Shake it out. Shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. Bring it to your shoulders and bring your elbows together again. This time your fingers are on top of your shoulders. So you bring your elbows together and nice and wide. Inhale, exhale. Inhale again, exhale, inhale, exhale. And let's do a rotation now. Back and forth. Do what you can. Don't push too much. But don't be lazy either, okay? Do what you can. Together, out, together, out, together, out. And then let's reverse. Very good, reverse. Excellent. One more. And then bring it up here and then bring it down. And then back to center. Bring it one way down. And back to center. Let's see if you can bring our elbow down to the same knee. Let's do the same knee. Bring your elbow down to the same knee and then point the other elbow up. Make sure you're breathing in and exhale, bring the other one. And then back again. This is a good stretch for your back as well as the side of your ribs here and your spine. And one more time. And back to center. And then back here, put both your elbows down and bring them up again. This time, you're gonna go up and then you're gonna go across. So before you were here, now you're gonna bring it across, okay? If you cannot do it, don't worry about it, just go to the same place. Remember, you have to listen to your body. I cannot see and guide you because I'm not physically there with you, but you have to be your own judges, all right? Inhale, exhale. Do what you can. It's a little bit harder. Other side. What you can. And back. Bring your elbows together. Nice and out wide. And let's do a rotation of your upper arms. Up, inhale. Exhale. Make sure you're breathing. Inhale. Exhale. Slow movements. No hurry. Not going anywhere. And we are not going anywhere now, but pretty soon, inshallah, in another few months, who knows, we will be going somewhere. And slowly up and down, like you're rowing a boat. And just, you may also imagine right now at a place where you want to be. So again, dhyana, meaning concentrate on some flow in your mind. Inhale. Exhale. Now let's reverse the other way. inhale, up and down. The ultimate of the yoga is the union of mind, body and soul. And the limbs that I have been going through are leading us up to the samadhi, which is, we've been through that before, for the chakras and all. It all ends up at one point, and that's meditation and the art of meditation. And how can you, so if you follow all the seven limbs, that will lead us to meditation in a way that will be of benefit to us. Sometimes we have other stuff going on in our life, and that way keeps us away from the final meditational flow. So that's what all this yoga, of course, if your body is not strong, you cannot do anything. So you have to keep yourself fit in order to even function properly, right? So in the mind and body and soul. So the body has to be strong in order for the mind to grasp it and the soul to elevate. So that's why it's called union of mind, body and soul. So yoga teaches us all kinds of stuff, not just activity and making sure that we are sweating and all that stuff, which is good too. No harm in that, all right? Okay, bring your hands back to center and push your palms across each other. Take a deep breath in. And now we're gonna do our heads and our necks. So we're gonna go inhale and exhale. My arms are still together. My palms are together, but I'm just going to turn my head to one side. Doesn't matter which side. So just turn, inhale, look back. My upper body is straight. It's just my neck and my head that's moving. And my eyes are moving even further back. With your eyes, look even further back. So you actually also exercising your eyes muscles. And then come back center. And then let's do the other side. Again, as far as I can go, eyes looking back as far as you can, and then come back center. Inhale, exhale, again, as far as you can go, and then look up to the ceiling, and down to the floor, and then come back center. Big inhale, exhale. Back, as far as you can go. Look up, and then look down to the floor. And then come back center. Big inhale, and cross your arms in front of you. Exhale, up. Inhale, exhale down. Cross, inhale, up. Remember, when you're crossing, opposite arm comes in front. And up again. Cross, inhale, up. Exhale, inhale up, and just widen your legs a little bit, so you're a little bit about foot two feet apart or whatever is comfortable for you. And we're gonna go up, inhale, and bring your hands to your knees and go slowly down, roll yourself down, look down, inhale up, roll yourself up again, exhale slowly down, look down. Inhale, up. This time bring your arms up and come to cactus. Cactus is position where your shoulder and your elbow are at the same level. But if you're here, it is okay. All shoulders are different. So if you can bring yourself, don't go higher up. It's this position, right? So that's cactus. Or you can be here. That's fine. Inhale, exhale. Inhale again, hold your core tight, inhale, and then let's do a twist. So we're gonna twist to one side. My arms are moving parallel to each other, and then back to center. One more time, and back to center. One more time, inhale, exhale. One more time, inhale, exhale. This time you're bringing your arms down, so see what you can. If you can leave your shoulders parallel, that's better. But if you cannot, this is okay, right? It's just a little bit of a rotation of your shoulders. One more time, inhale, exhale, inhale. One more time. Now while you're here, you're gonna bend with your back is straight, head going down. So like you're falling, but you're looking forward and arms are still parallel to each other and you go down. Inhale up, Exhale slowly down. Inhale up again. Exhale slowly down. One more time. Inhale. Bring your arms up and cross palms together and bring it down and bring it back to your thighs. Inhale. Let's do a deep breath in and let's get all the frustration out, okay? Big inhale and you're gonna go ha, like a big ha, and stick your tongue out. So you're gonna let go of everything that's been holding back. Take a deep breath in. Inhale. One more. You can scrunch your face, inhale. Very good. Inhale up. And you're gonna go down, 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 as far as you can go, touch wherever. You can hold on to your legs or to the floor, wherever you can, to anchor yourself. You're gonna raise your other arm up. Inhale up, up. And come bring it down. One more time, other side. Inhale up. Exhale down, one more, inhale up. Exhale down, one more, last one, inhale. Exhale down, both arms up. And circle and bring it out. Back to your shoulder, up and down. Very good, and shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. Your legs, your arms, flesh, 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 everything. Bring your fingers. Let's keep tapping your feet and rolling your fingers over your thumb. Very good, very good. Star, close. Star, close. Star, close. One more star, close. And then let's do rotation. Rotation, and let's do it together, okay? So we don't waste time. So lift up both your feet and let's rotate your ankles and your wrists together. Very good. And feel it, like dhyana, meaning put your focus on those areas. Focus on those areas, don't just do it automatically. It's more beneficial if you experience it. And then the other way. Like, where are you feeling the pain right now? Where are you feeling some stress in your body right now? Feel it, right? The other way, good. And let's do our palms up and together. And out, together and back, together and back, together and back. One more, together and back. Last one, together and back. And let's bring them out. Let's do scissors, cross, out. Okay, if you cannot do both your hands and your feet, you can do one or the other, or rotate, take a few of the hands and then a few of the legs, whatever you can do. But the whole idea is to reverse what's on top, which leg and which arm. So every time it's gonna be, you have to reverse, okay? So do a few of those. Very good. Couple more. Excellent. Smile. And reverse. Dhyana. Concentrate. And feel. And bring it up. Let's do up if you can, and keep doing one more, up. All those mitais you ate, we need to work out now. And bring it up and down, very good, and shake it up. Let's bring our tips of our finger together, and then base of our palm together. So again, it's a rotation of your shoulders, feel it, this way and that. Yeah, excellent. Together and back, together and back, together and back. One more, and back, and bring it down. Let's do our feet up. Bring your toes together, base of your heel together. Toes, heel, toes, heel, toes, heel. One more, toes, heel. Last one, very good, and bring it down. And shake it up, shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. All right. Let's bring our our knee to our chest. Inhale, exhale. One more big inhale, exhale. Feel it, press it towards your chest. So your arms are doing all the work by pulling them together. So feel it in the upper arms. Everything is to feel today, all right? In and extend. Bring it up, extend, up. Now you can hold it and do it. That's fine, as long as you're doing it. Or you can just do it on its own, or just hold on to the bottom of it. The whole idea is not to be in a painful situation, but as well as you push a little bit to see what you can do and you cannot do, right? So push and up. Push, inhale, exhale. Push again. Very good, last one. And push and bring it down and shake it up. Shake it up, shake it up, shake it up. Very good. Come to the edge of the chair and lift it up again, and then let's bring it to the side and back. Side and back, side and back, side and back, side and back. One more, side and back, and bring it down. Let's do a little bit of tap, 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 tap. Again, I'm still at the edge of my chair. I'm gonna rotate. First, let's do rotation of our knee. So hold on under the thigh area here, and just point your toes down and rotate it. Cross, rotate. Let it swing like it's swinging by itself. And then the other way. Other way. Very good. And then bring it down. Again, a little bit of love there. Now bring up your whole leg up, and we're going to rotate through our hip. So again, edge of the chair is important. So again, one more time. One, two, three, four, five, and the other way. One, two, three, four, and five. And there you go. Let's do the other foot. Bring it up. Let's give it a little hug first. Show it a little love. There. And pull it out. And up. One, two. You can hold. You don't have to hold. Whatever works for you. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and last one, 10. Very good, and bring it down. Shake it up. Let's do the knee area. Lift it up. You can hold it, or you just leave it, whatever works for you. Point your toes down, and let it go in a circle. Slowly, don't have to rush, slow down. One, slowly, slowly, one way. One more, and then let's do the other way. Other way, excellent. That's very good. And bring it down. Love, love, love. Lift it up. Now we're gonna do with our around the hip area. So we're gonna lift it and rotate. Rotate. One, two, three, four, five. The other way. One, two, three, four, and five. Very good. And bring it down. Take it out. Let's go out and back in. Out and back in. One more. Out and back in. And shake it up. Still at the edge of the chair. Just move your, slide your one. So both feet are facing forward. Toes are forward. And my back is nice and straight. All right. So give yourself, make sure your spine is not erect, but relaxed, but still firm. Okay. Now, if you have problems, then it's okay to be behind and touch your chair. But try and see if you can stay a little bit erect, okay? Not erect, but away from the back, right? Okay, so slide your foot forward, 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 as far as it can go. And once it reaches its limit, you go on your heel. So your toes are going up, right? So you feel the back of the your calf as well as your thigh area. Really nice and strong. Feel it, feel it, feel it, and then bring your toes down, touch the ground, slide it back underneath your chair as far as you can go, and raise your foot up on your toes. So your toes are curled, and then you are your heel is up. So we're just gonna reverse that back again. Keep going forward, forward, forward as far as you can go. On your heel, toes up. And bring it down. Slide it back, 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 back. Now you're on your toes and your heel is up. Last one. Slide, 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 slide as far as you can go. Go on your heel. Feel that nice pressure on your calf area. Your toes are going up. And now you go down. Slide back as far as you can go under your chair. And then raise yourself up on your toes. Heel goes up. Okay? And then come back. Let's do the other foot. Slide, 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 slide. This is a good exercise to stretch your fascia. Because remember, we have talked about fascia that is covers the whole, it's like a lining that covers everything in our body. And each part that you stretch affects another part in your body too. All right, so this is a stretch of your fascia. So go forward. And then when you reach your limit, go up. Your toes go up and your heels go down. And you feel that nice stretch in your calf area there and upper thigh area. Nice, inhale. Exhale, bring it down. Bring your foot down, slide. The whole foot down, slide, slide under your chair. And it goes no further. You raise yourself up on your, so your toes are curled and your heel is up now. Okay? So that's just a movement like this. And go forward. And raise up. And then go down again. And back, 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 as far as you can go. And your heel is up. One more time. Forward, 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 forward. On your heel, toes are up. Last one. And then you bring it down and bring it back to center. Very good. Shake it out. All right. So bring your feet out far, farther away. Take a nice deep breath in. We're going to do cat and cow. So hold on to your, you don't have to be totally out. You can be about this much is good. Hold on to your knees and let's do some cat and cow, which is when you go forward, you inhale, your chin and chest forward. Okay, inhale. And feel that nice little bend of your back area there. Feel it, feel it, feel it, feel it. Inhale. And when you exhale, you round your shoulders and chin to chest. Inhale, chin forward, chest forward. Exhale, round your shoulder, chin to chest. Look down. One more time. Inhale, exhale. And bring your back to center. Raise both your arms up. Inhale, and come down between your legs as far as you can. And then walk to one side. Back to center, other side, as far as you can go. Back to center, inhale, both arms up. This time, we're gonna go down with both arms on one side. So go down, touch, inhale, up. Center, center, down, inhale, up. Other side, inhale, up. And bring your arms down and back to your knees. Let's do a little bit of a grind there, Sufi grind. Hold on to your knees, and then let's go forward. Inhale, exhale. Now, the rotation can be simple, or you can try and make a 360 turn. So my shoulder is trying to go across. All right, so it's a really 360 turn. So you can do this. It's really good for your spine, your internal organs. And breathe in, breathe out. One more time this way. It's called a Sufi grind. And let's do the other side now. Rotation on the other way. Slowly, slowly. You can close your eyes and do it. It's a very meditative for movement. And do what you can. Even a little you can, that's good. And back to center. Very good. Arms together, inhale up, inhale. Hold your breath. And exhale, slowly down. Exhale, exhale. Inhale again, inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold your breath. 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale slowly. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Last one. Inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold your breath. Hold your breath. Hold your breath. Hold your breath. Exhale slowly. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring your arms out and back. Cross, out, cross, out. One more time, cross, and bring it down. Shake it up. All right, let's do the our lower back movements. So you can be here, cross, and then you can hang on here. If you can't go any further, then this is good. Or you can bring your knee up and hang on to your both your knees. I mean, with both your hands, or put it on your knees. Okay? Or the third position. All three will do the same thing, but do what your body allows you to do. Don't force. The third position is this, where my foot is down, pointing forward, toes pointing forward, flat on the ground, doesn't move. And then my knee is up here. I hold on either here or here, wherever I can anchor. Back is nice and straight. Inhale. And exhale, chin forward, chest forward, go down as far as you can. If you feel any pressure or pain, is that where you stop? Alright? Only do what you can. Inhale up, exhale slowly down. Inhale up again. This time the arms go up, nice and tall, bring it close to your ears. And exhale, go down again. Straight arms down, look forward, only do what you can. This is really good for your lower back, for sciatica. A lot of us have pinched nerves, and this relaxes this movement. But again, remember, don't overdo it, okay? Only do what you can. Inhale up. Last one, exhale down. Inhale up. And this time you're gonna turn to one side, doesn't matter which side. And the outer arm will go back, and you look at your arm, and your inner arm will hold on to the chair or to your legs or the handle of the chair, whatever is available for you. And then look back, hold the pose, but breathe through it. Breathe through it. Very good. And hold your arms up, inhale, exhale to the other side. Again, the outer arm goes out. Inner holds on to your to anchor something, and look back, breathe through it, breathe through it, hold the pose. Very good. Inhale up, both arms are up now, and then bring it to cactus. And yes, you're gonna do the eagle. So cross your elbow, or you can stay here. This is good enough. If you cannot go any further than this, this is good. Otherwise, you can open and become, you can clasp here, like back of your arms touching each other, or you can make palms touching each other, okay? Inhale, up, 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 up. Exhale, slowly down. Inhale, up, 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 up. Exhale, slowly down. Let's do a twist. So go this way, one way, doesn't matter which way, only what you can do, and look back, and then come back forward. Other side. And back to center, and arms go up, and away we go. Fly like an eagle. Fly one way, fly the other way. And bring your arms up, inhale, and exhale down. Bring your chin, to, I mean bring your knees to your chest, and let's give it some love. All right, good job. Thank you. Relax, everything relax, relax, loosey-goosey, right? Now we're gonna do the other foot. Again, this is good. Everything we do like this and everything is the same. Or you can go here. Okay, and then you can hold on here. Or you can go like this. Hang on to your knee and your ankle or between your legs. Nice and tall, inhale. Exhale. Inhale again. Exhale, come down, come down, come down. I prefer holding it here because it widens up, gives me space. So then I go down, Youth forward, chin forward. Only do what you can. One side may be better than the other, which is fine. Okay, look forward. Inhale up. Exhale, go down. Chin forward, chest forward, look forward. And feel that little pull in the back, but don't go where it's pain. Okay, just do what you can. Inhale up. Arms up. Nice and tall. And then come forward, forward, forward. Arms forward, look forward. Inhale up. One more time, exhale. Very good, inhale up. Just feel it. And we're gonna do the twist. So again, twist one side. Outer arm goes out, inner arm holds on. Look back, breathe through it, hold the pose. Hold the pose. Smile, inhale up. Nice and tall. Other side, arm goes out, one inner arm holds on. Very good, excellent. Look back, breathe, hold the pose. Inhale, arms up, exhale, down. Again, we're gonna cross the other arm on top now. Reverse. You may think you don't remember, but you will feel the difference because the brain remembers. Okay, so you give yourself a hug. You can stay here or you can expand further. So back of your arms touching each other or your palm to palm. Whatever you can do, do not judge. Okay, it's an eagle pose. Up, inhale, exhale, down. Inhale, up, exhale, down. One more big inhale. Exhale, and let's do a twist. Breathe through it. Back to center, other side, back to center, arms push out, and float away. There, float away. Freedom. Yes, we're gonna get that freedom, hopefully soon. And bring your knee to your chest. Nice little squeeze. Mwah. Very good. Now come back to the edge of the chair, clasp your hands together, and then just feel that nice stretch. Okay, up, up, up. Inhale, one side, and center. Other side, and center. And then forward, bring it down, 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 down. You're still stretching. Up again. Okay, now this time I want you to let go and bring it behind your backs the same way, clasping your hands. So basically you're gonna go like that, but behind your back, okay? If you're standing, then you know what to do. And I'm gonna be at the edge of the chair. And if you're standing, you can do the same. You can stand up and do this. Inhale, exhale, bring your arms up as far as you can. And look down, bend down, look down, and back again. Inhale. Exhale again. One more, inhale. And bring it down. Very good. And now let go. Shake it up. Shake it up. And hold on to your chair or the hands of your chair. Whatever works for you. And I'm going to slide both my feet forward. This flat on the ground. I'm going to raise myself up by holding on to the chair. Alright. So I'm right there. My shoulders are spread back. Stretch back. Inhale. And I'm going to lift myself up. Inhale. Look up. Stay there. Breathe. Breathe, stay there, breathe, breathe, stay there, breathe. And bring yourself down again. Make sure you're sitting back on the chair. One more time, inhale. Exhale. Next inhale, you lift yourself up. Inhale, up. Hold it, hold it. And bring it down. Very good. Now bring yourself a little bit behind, not right to the edge, but you're going to do the same. Slide. Now this time we're gonna go up and then bend one foot and then bring the other one up. Inhale, exhale. Very good. Point and then bring it down and back down. Okay, so bend your knees, both knees. All right. Slide just one foot up, not the other, and then raise yourself easier. And then raise your slided foot up. Very good. Do what you can. Don't force yourself and bring it down. Very good. Excellent. Whew. All right. Shake it out. Very good. We're going to stand up now. All right. So come to the edge of the chair. Arm to the side. Raise your hands up and lift yourself up. So remember what I taught you. You're not going to go over your knees. You're going to go, your back is going to stretch out. Okay? Pull it down a bit. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm my leg, my knee is over my ankle and my butt is sticking out. So that's my chair pose, okay? And bring your arms together out. Inhale. Exhale. Just squat. One, two, three, four, and up, arms go up. Inhale, up, up, up. And exhale down. Very good. Let's go behind your chair. And let's do the toes, okay? I'm just going to grab some water. You do the same. Alright, so I'm going to, you can be like this, and we're going to go up and down, up again, inhale, exhale down, one more, inhale up, exhale down, and go on your heels and your toes. So you're rocking back and forth, rock back and forth, very good, and bring yourself down. Now you're gonna go on your toes a little bit. Don't have to go too high. Just I'm gonna face this way so you can see me. So I'm gonna go on my toes, but about an inch, 2 inch. And I'm still holding on with both my arms or one arm, whatever works for you. You can do it on the side too, whatever works for you. Listen to your body. Don't fall. And I'm just balancing on my toes this time. Okay. Very good. And then you can let go if you like. Or you can hang on with one arm or two arms. And just balance, focus on a point in front of you, soft gaze, breathe normal, dhyana, remember? Immerse your whole body in that particular thought. And then that way you'll be able to concentrate longer and stay on your toe longer. And then you come down, very good. And just shake it up, shake it out, shake it out, kick, kick, kick. Let's kick, kick, kick. Kick forward. Kick backwards. Kick backwards. And you can lift your foot up. So see if you can hit your butt. Up, 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 up. Keep doing that. Few of those. It's good for your quads here. Nice and kick, kick, kick. So we did kick up, up. Lift your foot up and up. So high as you can, up, 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 and then back, 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 and back, 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 up, up, up. All right, good for you. Now let's do sideways, out and cross, up and cross, up and cross, up and cross, up and cross. Very good. Let's do the other one. Very good. All right, let's do one cycling movement, then we'll go into some rest, okay? So rest, up, up, up and circle, 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 and then the other way, circle. So like you're cycling with one foot. Very good, and you're actually working on your quads here too, and your core. And let's do the other foot, up, circle, circle, circle. Circle, one more, other way, excellent, and bring it down, right, shake it up, bring lift up, and then go on the side, and bring it back, side, bring it back, side, bring it back, and down, up, side, back, side, back, side, back, last one. Very good. And now just stand still in mountain pose with your feet facing forward on the side, arms on the side. Inhale. And knees don't have to be tight, they just be relaxed. They're straight, but they are not like this or they're not like this. They're just relaxed, okay? Arms to the side. Close your eyes for a little while. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale again. Very strong pose, mountain pose. Inhale, arms up, up, up. Inhale. Exhale, we're gonna go squat. Inhale, up. Nice and tall. Exhale, bum sticking back, knees over ankle. Up again, one more. Inhale, and right down there. Very good. Come back out and give yourself a nice little hug. Right, we're gonna do one balance more and then we're going to rest, okay? All right, so let's see. We're gonna do, just go behind your chair. I'm gonna be on the side, or you can be on the side. Lift one leg up and keep holding onto the chair, or one hand, two hands, doesn't matter. We've done this before. And just lift, doesn't have to be very high. Just 6 inches above the ground is good, okay? And then you let go of one arm. Hold on with one, hold on the chair with one arm and let go with the other arm. So I'm still holding, this is free. And only if I'm comfortable, I will let go, okay? Otherwise I'll hang on, okay? Breathe, focus, dhyana. Soft gaze, breathe. You may be wobbly, but just breathe, concentrate, and then bring it down. Very good, and shake it up, okay? And let's do the other foot. Back again, up, doesn't have to be high, 6 inches is good. Hang on there, inhale, exhale. I'm holding on with one arm, other arm is free. Only, and I can stay there, that's fine. Or even with two arms is okay, because you're still feeling that little strength in the calf area, okay? If I'm ready, I can let go. One side may be stronger than the other. Breathe, focus. And there are days where you feel like you cannot do either. It's okay. It's where your mental state is on that day. So some days you'll be very good at it. Some days you'll be wobbly. Some days you just cannot do it. But that's because of our mental state. That's why this concentration is so important. Inhale, exhale, and then bring it down. Shake it up. All right.
Okay.
Roshan. Bring your arms to your chest. always touches our hearts for sure. I'm going to now just start with the meditation. So just relax, sit at the edge of the, sit relaxed, sit comfortable. You can be on the floor, or you can be on the chair, or you can be heads, legs raised to the chair or sofa or on the wall, whatever is working for you, but be comfortable, okay? And we're going to do this one. It's called, it's a meditation called newness through a clean mind. And a clean mind means getting all the junk rot out of our mind so we can concentrate on the journey of our soul, which is the ultimate. Okay? So just relax, close your eyes. You can keep your palms up, down, doesn't matter, but just relax the whole thing. Enjoy. Sorry. Soft breaths.
To experience newness in my life, all I have to do is clean my mind. All I have to do is let go of everything old that keeps me from seeing the beauty in each moment. I have to let go of everything old that keeps me from seeing the wisdom or the gift in each moment. And so I prepare to do that right now. Right now, I let go of all my old habitual ways of thinking. I let go of all the old thoughts that run through my mind each day. And I ask myself, who am I without those thoughts? Let me enter into that peace. Let me enter into that mystical quiet. To experience newness each day and in each moment, I also have to be willing to let go of over-identifying with my history. So let me let go of everything that's happened in the story of my life. Let me let go of my history, even if only for a few moments, and just be in that deep silence, completely free and naked of the world, but yet able to perceive the beauty of the world. Let me release the world from my mind and enter into that quiet. That is my true nature. This practice alone allows me to perceive my life and each moment of my life with fresh eyes, with eyes that are able to see the significance of the situations around me, with eyes that are able to see the beauty of the moments around me. Let me come to each moment clean, free of history, free of old habitual ways of thinking. And even if I only do this for a few moments each day, the effects will be profound. The quietude that it brings to my life will be profound. And so now I return to the world. But I vow to practice this today, to enter into each moment, each interaction, each scene of my life, free of history, and free of all the habitual ways of thinking. Let me be more truly myself. Let me be stable and at peace today as much as possible.
You may open your eyes, bring your hands to heart. Take a deep breath in, up, 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 inhale, inhale. Nice and tall. Exhale slowly down, bring your arms forward, right behind your chair as far as you can go. Inhale up again. Touch your palms together and then bring them back to heart. Arms out. Lots of good energy to you guys. And I'm gonna grab some from you to me today. Inhale, nice and large. Exhale, bring it back to your heart. And let's do a little circle. Nice little circle, one way and the other way. Smile, life is good, we're still here. And bring back to your heart. Thank you, Yali Madad, and Namaste.